What's up, y'all? It's your boy Spidey Studios here, and today I am here with a brand new reaction for the channel. This is Superman and Lois. This is obviously not Lois, this is Steel. And we just got here today, funny enough, so it's a good thing I waited until today to react to it. In honor of Superman and Lois reaction today. Obviously, unfortunately, I couldn't react to it the day it came out, which was Tuesday night. Technically, I would have reacted to it Wednesday, but Wednesday I had a special anniversary day to do, so I didn't have time to react to it. But today, I have the time, and I definitely want to get into it. I love this show. The show is too good. Probably the best superhero television family drama series ever, and it's unfortunate that due to budget cuts, a lot of these characters are not going to be series regulars next season. Unfortunately, one of them is Steel, which I think this show definitely made this probably the best character and the best version of this character in live action, which prompted me to buy this figure, because I love this character so much now. But yeah, so I'm just excited to see what we're going to get. I obviously know that everybody was blowing up about it yesterday. Lex Luthor makes his first appearance in this show. The new actor this episode. Now that Bruno Mannheim has been taken care of and thrown behind bars, we know that Lex Luthor is going to appear in this episode. Obviously, that was the tease. I didn't think he would appear, like, literally the last two episodes of the show. I thought that he would appear much sooner than that. But, I mean, I'm glad he's here. I'm just surprised that he's appearing in the last two. Now, obviously, if you don't know this, I don't think this will necessarily be spoilers because everybody kind of confirmed this, but it is confirmed that Lex Luthor will be a series regular next season. So next season, he will be a series regular. So he's not going to die in this show or, you know, be defeated so easily within two episodes. So that's good. At least we get more of him. But that doesn't explain exactly what we are going to get in these final two episodes. Maybe something to do with Bizarro, because we know Bizarro is alive now. We don't know what's going on with him, but we know he's alive. So maybe that might be something, but I don't know. I guess we're going to see what we see. So without further ado, I just want to jump into this episode to see what they gave us. So we are starting right now. Will he keep it a secret? Good to have an alien as a husband. Lois gets cured or something. Thank you. Metropolis braces for Alito's rule. He's full of bullet holes. Who's that? Lena? The sister? Striker's prison. Is my man ruling this prison? Is that what's happening? I'm excited. The way that they've been talking about Lex all season, I'm excited. Talking to someone from the Daily Planet? Damn it. Damn it. No. About his secret to anybody. Shut your fucking mouth. Especially with Lex getting out of jail. It's the worst time to bring up your identity. Wife? Who is he married to? Classic name. Classic. and still has connections even outside of prison. What is happening? No. Jesus. He's a lot scarier than any Lex I've seen. Most Lex aren't as scary, but they're just... So true. I mean, that is true. It would have happened at any time. I think Kyle is cool. I understand both sides of this. Like, obviously you're gonna treat the son of the greatest superhero ever with a bit more respect, understandably. But at the same time, I understand Jordan's point, or Jonathan's point, where he wants to be treated with more respect because, like, he wants to be treated with more respect because, there's no way you're gonna make it to work walking. Are you serious? So for 2 decades, he's just been chilling in prison, just waiting for the time to get out. Because you just want his cell? Jeez. What's so special about his cell? This Lex is terrifying. Like, he's not as sarcastic and witty as normal Lexes are. Like, even the one from Supergirl was a bit more sarcastic-ish to a degree, just because of the tone of that show. But even Lex, like, in other stuff was, like, a bit more sinister, but he wasn't as serious. This Lex is far more serious. What? Or tornado warning? Yeah, Clark, clap the tornado. You've done it before in comics. Jeez. Thank you, Sarah. Has there ever been a tornado in Smallville? Other than, like, back in the day? I know that happened in the Smallville show once, I think. Yeah, you gotta go. You gotta run. Jeez. Is he gonna fly the opposite end to disrupt the tornado? Ah, that's cool. Flash did that. Oh, damn. Oh. At this point, you gotta do what you gotta do. Oh, he's freezing the tornado. That's interesting. At least have Jordan protect Lois. Why are you still standing there? That they're freezing the tornado. I mean, Clark in the comics just clapped the tornado away once. Oh, fucking A. No. God damn it. Damn it, now everybody knows who he is. Fucking A. he doesn't even wear, he doesn't even have glasses, so he can't disguise himself even. Clark had the excuse. He didn't stay in Metropolis after that. Both their points, I do. Here? He walked all the way from prison to here? The hell? Even through a tornado you walked here? Daughter? What? Jeez. This like scary. I'm terrified. Thank you. God. Otis? That's Otis? Wait, isn't that the dude he beat up? It's hard to tell. Wasn't the guy he beat up in prison? So this Lex had a kid? Jeez. I mean, he looks old enough. I would have assumed. Because they're all older versions of the typical versions of the characters we have. Because, like, in the comics, you can't really tell that much time has passed. But in live action, yeah, you can tell that these characters are much older. Jeez. I'm surprised he got the beard. For over 2 decades. That is the same guy he beat up. He knows about Bizarro too? This is great writing. Lex just showed up in the last 2 episodes and has already taken center stage. Something to do with Bizarro, though, because he knows about Bizarro being down there. Again, the fact that he just knows all this stuff so quickly is ridiculous. didn't he escape? Why did he just stay down there? Guess that's the end of Otis. Dude. Holy shit. That was a great episode. Lex showed up in the final two and took center stage in this one. Wow. Man. That was just great. I loved everything about that episode. I'm really excited. I enjoyed this episode. Everything about it was so good. I don't even know what the play is for, but that was great. I'm definitely glad that this Lex is going to be more central focused than the next season, because instantly I love him. He's really good. Like, he's different from every other Lex that I've seen, but not completely different. It still feels the same, but enough where I'm like, this is great. Like, I love everything about this. Alright, well, I'm excited to see how this all ends. I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction to this amazing show, season 3, episode 12. I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction to this. If you guys didn't, let me know in the comments down below what you really thought of this episode was. I'm curious to see what you guys thought of the next conversation down below. Drop a like on the video for your boy. Hit the subscribe button. Community. See you guys in the next episode next, and we'll see you guys in the finale. Peace.